तत्परंपर्याय विद्महे ज्ञानलिंगेश्वराय धीमहि तन्नो गुरुः प्रचोदयाते। ओम योग महर्षि डॉक्टर स्वामी गीतानंद गिरि गुरु महाराज की जय। नमस्ते एंड वेलकम बैक एंड another session. And this morning when I got up, I was thinking, what do I do today? What do I start today? And different ideas were going on. And I was thinking, should I do this? Should I do that? Should I open up a page of the correspondence course step by step and see what Swamiji wants me to teach? And I had sort of prepared myself to actually start on something. And then I saw a message from a dear indirect student of mine. An indirect student in the sense of when I go and teach in other institutions, in other traditions, many of the students who are there start to sort of get attached to me and start corresponding with me. But what I like to always tell people is that you need to be loyal to your tradition. So that is why I use the word indirect student. Some of them, I have actually told them, I'll consider you a friend. I will help you. It doesn't diminish the relationship. But I do not want to be seen as stealing students from other institutions and other places. Because as you know by now, I am not interested in having more sheep in my stable. So one of these indirect students who has been close to me for many years sent an email. It was actually a message on Facebook this morning. And then I realized I need to address this topic, a very important topic during this physical isolation that is happening. And because we use the term social isolation, people think you have to socially disconnect from everyone. We have to be very careful with the words we use, because words are very powerful. And what happened is, the safety experts in health, they said, we have to keep you isolated in the lockdown so that we try to reduce the spread of the infection, flatten the curve, all these terms you have been hearing. And so they introduced what was called social distancing. A big mistake. The moment we hear the word social distancing, we think I should not speak to anybody. I should not communicate with anybody, because man, human being, is a social animal. We are a social animal. We need social relationships. It is the social relationships that enable us to grow. It is the social relationships that enable us to be ourselves and retain some level of sanity in a world that is increasingly becoming insane. My father so many times used to say the planet Earth is the insane asylum of the universe, and that all the mad people All the insane people would be sent to earth. And as a kid, I used to say, Swamiji, that's not nice to say that because it means that all of us human beings are insane. As I grow older and hopefully a bit wiser, at least the white hair. That's why I leave my hair white. In fact, when I started getting white hair, I was very happy. Finally, people can start to take me seriously because they'll say, he has white hair, so he may have some wisdom. Because otherwise, what happens is that you are the youngest in all these places and they think you are so young, you don't know anything. And the new kid on the block and like, stay in your place. Especially in Indian society, where everything is based on age. If you're older, you know it all. And if you're younger, you know nothing. So the white hair sort of maybe a bit wiser. Definitely older. Definitely older, but maybe wiser. I've come to realize, yes, my father was right. Swamiji, you are right. This is an insane asylum. And people just mistake everything. So the health authorities say social isolation, social distancing, and immediately people stopped talking to the neighbors. They stopped phoning anybody. They stopped sending emails. They stopped communicating with even their own family members. They stopped smiling at each other. Seriously. As it is, we don't smile. On top of that, now we have this mask. We already have a mask, a persona. On top of that, we have a mask. At work, I often have trouble recognizing fellow colleagues because of the mask these days. It is physical distancing. Physically, you need to keep some space, be it 3 feet or 6 feet or 60 feet. Physically, you need to keep space, not emotionally, not socially. These are the times we need to communicate and reach out to each other more than ever. More than ever, we need to be communicating with each other. Why do you think for the last 96 days, I have been reaching out? This is not self-promotion. This is not so that all of you can say, Dr. Ananda exists. This is my way of communicating with all of you out there. Saying that, don't worry, we are in this together. Abhaya Mudra, fear not, as is said by Lord Muruga in our culture, the Tamil god is Lord Muruga. Yam irukka bayam edu endru, yam irukka bayam edu endru, abaya karathudane kaatchi tharuvaan velan, abaya karathudane kaatchi tharuvaan velan, bayam edu maanida irulagandai soonda bayam edu maanida. Why should we fear? Fear not when the divine is with us. We need to be with each other. These hands are meant to connect our heart, connect with each other. And if you cannot hug each other physically, hug each other virtually. Send a few hugs to people. When you're talking to people, say, okay, here's a warm hug. Okay, all of you out there today, here's a warm hug. Love you all too much. Okay? That's the hug for the day. When you hug, a very, very important hormone from the posterior pituitary is secreted, oxytocin. Oxytocin is the hormone that enables parturition to occur, that is the baby to be born. The contraction of the uterus that enables the baby to be born. This oxytocin is the same hormone that enables the mother and the child to bond. The bonding hormone is oxytocin, the posterior pituitary. Neurohypophysis. Kattipudi Vaithyam. There was a Tamil movie, Vasul Raja MBBS, based on Munnabai MBBS, which is, talks about the hugging therapy. Why? Because the hands are connected to the heart. So when you hug, you are connecting heart to heart, soul to soul, human to human. So many people around the world, that the bigger issue today than even COVID-19 is the fact that there is such a rise in psychological distress. Psychological distress is on the rise. People are anxious. People are depressed. The whole stress response has been brought out in its peak level, magnified. Prasupta tanu vichinna udharanam. The stress response in udharanam level. So important to connect. And this is why we need to rephrase this term. Stop saying social isolation and social distancing. It is physical distancing. It may be a physical isolation. I accept there may be a need for that. I am not saying go out and hug everybody on the street and spread COVID-19. I'm not saying that. What I'm saying is we need to connect. There are many ways you can connect. Talk to each other. The internet is there. The mobile phones are with us 24 hours a day. We use it for so much nonsense. Why not to communicate with each other and just let people know, I am there for you if you need me. I am just a call away. And give people a caring, loving ear. An ear that listens. Not just hear. All ears hear. Very few listen. Because listening is an active process. Hearing is a passive process. You have to hear whether you like it or not. But you can choose to listen or not. Listen to other people. You don't have to give them solutions, I'll tell you. There was a beautiful story I read about this. Where a person had been phoned after midnight by someone who was on the verge of committing suicide. And this person took a couple of hours on the phone giving all the reasons why this young person shouldn't commit suicide that day. Finally, at the end of the conversation, the person said, "Thank you, sir, for being with me and all this time. And I decided I will live and do my best." As I told someone today, no one is perfect. We are all perfection in progress. We are perfection in progress. But we are not perfect. Nobody is perfect. So don't expect your teachers. People in the West got disillusioned by so many yoga masters because they thought they were perfect. As long as you're human, you cannot be perfect. So there will always be something. Gods with feet of clay, and then immediately everybody goes the other end of the spectrum. So this person said, "I have decided, sir, to live on, and thank you very much." A couple of days later, this person met. They met each other. And so the person who had been on the phone asked the young person, "Just, I'm curious, which of the reasons I gave you, I'd given you a dozen reasons why you should live." And he said, "Which of these reasons convinced you to live and not take your life?" And the young person said, "None of them, sir." He was surprised. The person said, "None of those reasons convinced me. But the fact that I could talk to you, there was somebody who valued my life enough to listen to me. Someone was there to whom I could express what was going in inside me and I could let it out. That is what gave me the relief and made me realize life is worth living. It's none of the logical reasons. So don't think there has to be a logical reason. It's not the logical reason. It is the fact there is a caring human being at the other end of the line. Depression is a major issue. And we don't talk about it enough. The blues. The dog of depression, as they often talk about. We don't see it. We don't realize it. What we need to realize is that we are all going to have these lows. We are all going to have those moments of asking ourselves, is it all worth it? Jeene ka matlab kya hai? What is the purpose of living? Varan the enna prajanam is a question that often comes up. Yadukume prajanam illa, idhu setthu pona. It's better to die than this. These are things that come up in everyone. This is the very thing that Lord Rama had as a teen. This is the very thing that Arjuna had. This is the very thing that so many. And that is why the whole Bhagavad Gita starts with Arjuna Vishada Yoga. The yoga of depression of Arjuna. The yoga of depression. Why is it yoga of depression? Because from that starting point, the lowest of the low, the only place you can go is up. It's like in the yantric cycle, the bottom of the four. Once you hit the bottom of the four, that nadir of the four, you just go up. That's why the five is so dynamic going up. June was a 4 month for me. I'm happy when July started. Depression is real. And depression is very, very, very important. Very, very important to deal with it. What we need to understand is there's nothing wrong in it. There's nothing wrong. Nothing to be ashamed of. As Ammaji says, 99 times down, the shame is if you don't get up, that 100th time. Kuppa vilundhalum meesa illa mannu ottala. Even if you fall down, there's no sand on your mustache. You have to get up. How you get up is the skill. All of us fall down. I fall down so many times. And I know so many of my dear yoga people, amazing people, amazing teachers who have inspired thousands. And yet they also have these down moments. Each one of us has it. If you are human, you are going to have it. Don't think somebody else doesn't have it. As someone said, is Dr. Ananda always happy? Well, come and ask my wife, come and ask my kids, come and ask my mother, and then you'll know. He's not always happy. But happiness, joyfulness is my nature. And when I connect to my nature, that manifests. When I disconnect from my nature, I lose it. And that is why it is so important to keep reconnecting. We need to be there. We need to be there to help others. We need to be strong. So one of the best things we can always do, and you all know what's coming now, is to start working on the solar plexus. This solar plexus is the part we need to work on. Remember, this is the sun. This is the moon. The ha and the ta. And there's nothing to beat the solar plexus when it comes to getting out of depression. So let's do some. Ha, 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 ha. And when you make that ha, see this area. Ha, 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 That ha has to come from here. That good belly laugh, huh? Ha ha ha. So important. And you can always add to it. The hakara kriya. Breathing in and out. Ha! In. Ha! And when you do in, you clap. So you are clapping, okay? Ha! 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 And just to add variety, because variety is the spice of life, you know, you go. Ha! 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 After doing that, if you still feel depressed, I'm going to punch you in your face. You have to get up and do something. If you sit there, oh poor me, oh poor me, oh poor me, oh poor me, you're not going to go anyplace. Get up and do that. Jump around, let the heart beat. The heart starts going faster. It says, hey, heart going faster, you must be excited. Hey, good. The blood starts to flow around the body. Oh, you must be feeling good. Blood is moving. And what have you done? You have used the body to influence the mind. We always talk of psychosomatics. There's a whole aspect of somatopsychics. When you start to use the body in a positive manner, you start to influence the mind in a positive manner. And that is why whenever you are feeling down, go out for a walk, go and cycle, go jump, and do some ha, 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 ha. Get that ha going. You look so ugly when you go. Ha. Have that. Let that come. And automatically when you do ha, this is the region, there's a lot of serotonin. This is the region also there's serotonin. What is serotonin? Feel good. The feel good substance in your brain, the neurotransmitter that makes you feel good. When you go ha ha, this part goes ha ha, you have triggered off endogenous serotonin. Endogenous, which means you have triggered it from within. You don't need a pill. You don't need an injection of serotonin. You don't need a pill of serotonin. You don't need an implant of serotonin. You have endogenously from within, you have started to get the serotonin process going. That is why yoga therapy is empowering. And for those in the new definition of IIYT for yoga therapy, I totally refuse to accept it without the word empowering. It has to be empowering the individual. The individual is taking the power in their hands. If it doesn't empower the individual from within, if they are not given the responsibility and the choice of their own health and happiness, it is not yoga. If you are doing it for somebody, it is not yoga therapy. As my father would say, modern yoga therapy is physiotherapy in an Indian clothes. It has to come from within. It is a self-healing. It is the fact that the person now feels, I can do it for myself rather than somebody will do it for me. Which is the whole healthcare situation. Somebody will do it for me. The doctor will repair me. The physical therapist will do it to me. Somebody will do it to me. Somebody will put pins into me. Somebody will press some part. Somebody will give me an injection. Somebody will lift me up. Somebody will crank up my bed. No. Nobody. You for yourself. Do it yourself. That is the message of yoga. We have to empower the individual to realize, when I feel depressed, what do? I don't have to take a pill. I have to start saying to myself, Ananda, this is not you, get out of it. How to get out of it? I cannot talk myself out of it because the mind has created the problem. How will the mind solve it? So the body has to come in. Use the body to affect the mind. And the somatopsychics come alive and you go, ha, 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 ha. And suddenly you feel better. You cannot go, ha, 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 and still feel depressed. You cannot. That is why yoga and yoga therapy have to come from within. And we want it to fit into some system just because we want to get insurance, just because we want to fit into somebody else's paradigm. Don't lose the identity of yoga and yoga therapy, which is to give the whole key, the big button. The power of the button is with that individual. You help them help themselves. And that is why, ha, 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 ho, 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 he, 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 me, 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 go, 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 ha, 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 ho, 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 he, 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 me, 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 go, 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 go. If after all of that you still feel depressed, oh my God. Huh? The great Tamil culture, the Dravidian culture, was so wise. All the ancient cultures, all the ancient cultures had great wisdom. And the Purana Nuru, 400 verses, Naal Nuru means, Naal means 4, Nuru means 100. 400, Purana Nuru, Agana Nuru, there are two great Tamil literature. The Purana Nuru deals with the external world, Puram. Bahya Puram. And it says, Thidum Nandrum Pirar Taravara. Both the bad and the good, the negativities and the positivities, are not given by somebody else. Nodalum Tanidalum Avatrohanna. Within us, we have the power that is causing both the depression as well as the coming out of it. Nodalum, the pain, the suffering, the depression. As Patanjali says when he talks of the Vikshepa, Sahabhuvaha. He says the Sahabhuvaha that is there. Dukkha Dhavarmanasya Angame Jayatva Shwasa Prashwasa Vikshepa Sahabhuvaha. They are the accompanying symptoms of all the internal obstacles. Dukkha Dhavarmanasya, suffering, depression, trembling, and an erratic breathing process. Nodalum Tanidalum Avatrohanna. We have both the problem and the solution lie within us. The moment we realize that, we realize we are not looking for somebody else to give us the answer. The other person can be a patient, active listener. They can be a support system, but the answers come from within. As they say, change and transformation have to come from within, which means that we have to enable the person to find that. I have a question about chemical imbalances in the brain and mental health. Can these movements help? Yes, absolutely. See, that the whole thing is every chemical reaction in the body that is triggered by an emotion or the lack of the emotion, the thought or the lack of the thought. Everything is connected, mind and body. So when the mind sends a signal, the body has the chemical peptide. But if the mind is not doing it, the thoughts are not doing it, the emotions are not doing, are not allowing it to happen through the bodily movement. That is why when you feel down, you just get up and run around, do some cycling, do some work, do some dance, do a nice Surya Namaskar, and you feel better. But if you sit in the same place doing nothing, nothing is going to change. So it is so important that we do not sit in the same place doing nothing. We get up and we move. Because when we get up and move, we have brought about a change. As my father would say, if you are sitting down, standing, stand up. If you are standing, sit down. If you are lying down, sit up. Just a change in the body position starts to bring a change in the mind. This is why sitting in Vajrasana. When you sit in Vajrasana, what are you doing? When you sit in Vajrasana, you are bringing alive. Lift the self by the self. Immediately you feel more up. Because you cannot slouch. You cannot have the depressed thing. But when we sit like this, it's very easy to get this. Slouching is much easier here. That is why the Vajrasana is a human posture. Message for today. Nothing wrong with depression. Nothing wrong with feeling down. But what is important is to come out of it. To come out of it, we need to start making a change. Change your body position. Change what you are doing. Small changes bring about great transformation. Remember the snowball effect? You just have to start with a small snowball. And as it goes downhill, it's going to grow. So your effort, what you are putting, your effort is very, very important. Because that effort then snowballs. And you can have a positive snowball, which becomes a positive avalanche rather than a negative avalanche that is there. So important that we take care of ourselves physically, mentally, emotionally, spiritually, and that we are there for others who need help physically, mentally, emotionally, spiritually, financially, socially too. I think it is so important that we as a human race realize we are all together and every one of us impacts every other one of us. The moment we realize that, we take on the responsibility for being human. We start to fulfill what is called our Manushya Dharma. And at that time, we grow as humanity. Hari Om Tat Sat.